second before we move on. Here, somebody take this from me. Usually I wait till the end of the night to do this, but I don't know, something's different about tonight. It might just be me. But I sense such a tangible presence of God, and I just have to believe that maybe God is working on some people's hearts tonight already. And I know we're only, it's probably going to be a long show because we're only halfway through, and we were about to play a video, and it's really cool, and I'm excited for you to see, but I feel like it would ruin the moment. And I usually do this later, but y'all, I've been just giving an invitation to start following Jesus, because I believe that he is extending the invitation, saying, I want you to follow me. And y'all, there's been so many young people coming to these shows. And I believe that the generation, and this goes for anyone, but I do believe that the generation that is being most attacked right now might just be the generation that actually starts a revival in our nation. Yo, I could have been so messed up. I'm just so thankful that I found Jesus and I chose to follow him, because yes, life is not easy and it is filled with valleys and it is filled with all kinds of troubles, but thank you. Oh my gosh, you're precious. Thank you. I didn't know what was going on, but these babies just brought me some water. Thank you. That's amazing. And I'm just like, dude, if there's one Brandon in the room that needs to get peace with God and needs to start following Jesus, and it's going to transform his or her life, like, I've got to give this invitation. And so I'm going to make it quick because we still have more songs to sing. But here's the thing. The Bible says it is this simple, that if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, the one we've been singing to, the one who is in this room, then you will be saved. If you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth. And I don't know why some people, they're like, they're not wanting to like go all in with Jesus because they think you got to start wearing khaki pants and a polo shirt. Listen, you can be cool and follow Jesus, but truthfully, I mean, this invitation isn't to be cool. It is to be a fool. It is to be a fool for Jesus. And it's, you're going to have people hate you. You're going to have people make fun of you. But here's the thing. You can think up the best life, dream up your best life for yourself, but it would never compare to the life that Jesus has for you, the plans that he has for you. And so, I'll say one more thing, and then if anyone wants to pray this prayer, and there's no magic in the prayer, I'm no professional pastor, literally, I just want to create and facilitate a conversation between you and God. But I have three boys, cray-cray boys. Pray for mama. They're coming out on tour next week. It's about to be shenanigans. It's about to be crazy. But I have three boys. And there is my wife and my boys and the Lord. And there is nothing I love as much as them. I'm obsessed with my boys. And I can't imagine not having a relationship with my kids. I can't imagine a situation where they're running from me, hiding from me. I want them to bring all of their mess to me. I want to be the one to handle and walk with them through it. Yes, I want them to live a holy life, righteous life. But there's nothing that they could ever do that would ever make me want to not have a relationship with them. You realize that's a fraction of how God feels about you? He made you. He would have the best plans for you because you are his son, you are his daughter. And I don't know if this might be for one person, but I think it's worth going after, because if somebody can move from death to life tonight, from darkness to light, I think it's worth it. So if you want to pray that prayer, whether you want to come back home because you've been running from God for a season, or you want to say yes to Jesus for the first time, just repeat this after me. And if you're a believer, why don't you pray with me so they hear the church pray with them. Say, Jesus,
Jesus.
Here I am.
Here I am.
I'm a sinner.
I'm a
I'm in need of a Savior.
And I believe that you
are that Savior.
Sent by your Father
to take on a cross.
To pay for my sin.
You were buried.
But 3 days later,
you rose again.
So that I could have a relationship
with my Heavenly Father.
So tonight,
I want to go all in.
I want my old life
to die.
And may my new life
be resurrected in Jesus.
I want to be born again.
I want to follow Jesus
for the rest of my days.
And spend eternity
in heaven.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Right, this is weird. This is usually what I do on the end of the night. I have completely screwed up our whole night. And sorry, not sorry. Everybody put your bracelets behind your back real quick. Hide that light. Normally say, don't hide your light. Let it shine. But for this moment, if you prayed that prayer, and don't start clapping for them at least for 3 seconds after, if you can't be bold inside this room with thousands of people who believe in Jesus, it's going to be hard to be bold out there. But I want you to hear the uproar of the church cheering you on for making the best decision of your life. If you just prayed that prayer, will you shake your hand violently up in the air? Right here. So proud of you. We got more songs to sing, and so check out this video and then we'll get back into it.